happy to be in person with you all again. So we do a faculty concert twice a year, once in the spring and once in the fall. The fall one, the spring one, the one you're here for tonight, is most of the music faculty. And the one in the fall is just for the jazz folks. So we started this concert about 16 years ago in order to support our students who needed funds in order to stay in school. And the original story is that we found out that one of our students was living in her car with a baby. And she had to make a decision about paying tuition and books and so forth and studying her music or getting an apartment.
Never give the talent a switch. So we started this concert, and we've kept hundreds of students enrolled in the college by the efforts of these concerts. And plus, it's an excuse for all of us to get together and make some music, which we don't get to do all together very often. So we're glad that you're here. Hello to the folks watching and listening on the internet. Thank you for joining us as well. So we're going to get this rolling here. So our first selections are by vocalist Chad Ruyle. Chad is a part-time faculty member teaching applied voice, in other words, teaching private voice lessons. He also teaches in a variety of other situations in this county and in Santa Barbara County. Attended Cal State Fullerton. And where else, Chad? Not that it matters, because if you go to Fullerton.
Cal State Northridge.
Okay, Cal State Northridge. So between Fullerton and Northridge, most of us are covered here on the faculty. And he's a very valuable member of our vocal faculty. Idona Cabrinha teaches piano classes, both beginning and intermediate piano. Degrees from Northwestern University and other places. She's a fantastic pianist, as you're about to hear. And she also composed one of the numbers coming up on the second half. So help me welcome then Chad and Idona.
Good evening, everyone. It's such a pleasure to be here, finally back in person. I'm sure that you've all been tuning in for the last couple years of the concerts that, and even me, I have to say, every time I would watch myself count down to these concerts, I would even get nervous watching myself. So it's actually cool to be live in person. I am so lucky to be getting to perform with my friend and colleague, Idona Cabrinha. We're going to bring a couple songs for you today. A Mexican folk song, which is called Mi Sueño, which is an adaptation and really very dramatic piece of a very bad breakup, I have to say. So if you think telenovela, this is songs right out of there. And a really cool Spanish bolero, which means a ballad, called Perhaps, 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 or you might know it by Quizás, Quizás, Quizás. And we are going to end this little set with a duet of Somewhere from West Side Story, and we will have our friends Emily, as well as Ron and Tom over here joining us. So thank you so much for being here tonight. Oh, okay. Somewhere is later, sorry. My mistake. All right, it's time for some Spanish.
Oh.
Idona. All right, and joining
the fray here is flautist, right? Flautist or flutist Ron McCarley. Ron heads our jazz program here at the school. He's in his 17th year here, incredibly. And he's a wonderful saxophonist as well, as you hear later, and he directs the rest of the big band and our expansive combos program. Degrees from Cal Arts and also Westmont College. That's Ron McCarley. And on percussion is Daryl Voss. Daryl can be with us tonight. He has a gig. He's out making some money, supporting him and his family. So joining us is one of our esteemed alumni. Tom Brown attended here, did just great work, and then went to Cal State Northridge and finished his degree, and he's a busy gigger all over the county. So that's Tom Brown.
Quizás
Thank you, everybody. So we have another real treat next. It's special when you have the composer of a work of music present, and in this case, conducting the work. That's a rare and very special treat. So Michael Walker, the composer, came to us from Texas, but he started around here. He was a Cuesta student way back in the early part of his career. And he's a wonderful pianist, wonderful composer, and he just decided that Texas wasn't for him, and he came out here blindly, and we happened to have a part-time job, and we snatched him up. He's a wonderful, wonderful musician and teacher. So we have Idona again on piano. On violin, we have our violin teacher here at the school, Emily Lanzone. She's the concertmaster of the Slow Symphony and plays professionally in lots of other situations here in town, a fantastic player. We passed through Reno professionally nearly at the same time. We think we might have known each other. Bill Albert on violin also is a wonderful player, plays in all the professional situations. And Bill and Karen on viola here are not really connected with the college, but they're here playing for us, and we really appreciate that so that we could realize Michael's score. And on cello, we have Ken Hustad somewhere. There he is. And Ken is a cellist and a bassist, principal bassist in the Slow Symphony. And you'll see him in lots of classical situations and jazz situations. He's a fantastic jazz bass player. And I've even seen him in like blues and kind of pop music situations, right? Is that fair? Kind of rock and roll situations. Yeah, he's saying, don't tell me. No, he's fantastic. So versatile. And on bass is Dylan Johnson. Dylan is there. Dylan went to college back in New York, upstate, right? Oh, wonderful.
10 miles from the city.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. Yeah, and Dylan for us teaches a history of jazz, history of rock and roll, and so forth. He's also a good guitarist and great electric bass player. That's Dylan Johnson. So enjoy Michael Walker's piece, Romanza for Piano and Strings. Michael Walker.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Michael. World premiere of a piece of music. There it is. Our next work is kind of a crossover work of classical and jazz. It's two movements of the suite for flute and jazz piano. They'll be performing the fifth movement first, and then the first movement second. So keep track of that, please. We feature on this tune Cassandra Tarantino. Cassie is a conductor, a flautist, a singer, a bon vivant around town. She's very active in the music scene in the county. Degrees from Westmont, from Cal State Northridge, and recently in choral conducting from San Jose State. She's a dear friend, and we're so happy that Cassie is on this concert. Conductor of the North County Chorus, the mighty North County Chorus. And joining her on piano is the chair of the music department here, John Knutson, pianist, singer, jazz artist, classical conductor, and he has the most thankless job on this campus, which is division chair in general, but particularly this division. Yeah. I have some experience on that. I can speak from experience. Ken is back on bass and Tom is back on drums. So music by Claude Bowling and Cassandra Tarantino.
Thank you.
So, we apologize for starting the concert slightly late. One of our dear friends that we wanted to make sure was here to start the concert was stuck on that accident on the grade. If you didn't hear about it, there was an accident on the grade, and like a fire and all sorts of things. But I'd like to introduce her and somebody else while we're here. The sponsor. Of all the Cuesta Performing Arts performances this whole school year, Joan Sargent is with us tonight. And along with Joan is another dear friend of all of us. I tell her the only mistake that she probably made while she was president of this college was hiring me 18 years ago. It's probably the only thing she regrets. She's a dear friend and was a wonderful president of this institution, Marie Rosenwasser. And before I forget too, I'd like to thank John Hurwitz and her team here, Clark and Allie and everybody who's making this concert run tonight and facilitating the building. Thank you guys very much. Like a lot of businesses in town, they are understaffed tonight, and so they are running back and forth doing a lot of things, plus the internet service, right? And so there's a lot going on tonight. We thank them for their really hard work. Ken and Dylan are back doing a bass duet. Is that cool or what? Duke Ellington's In a Mellow Tone.
Thank you.
Idona and Shad and Emily rejoin us. Be ready to have your heartstrings ripped out. We know that there's a new movie that came out this year of West Side Story. that I think is just dynamite. If you haven't seen and you're interested at all in this kind of music, I really recommend that you see it. I think it's just a dynamite kind of reworking of the story slightly. And we also know that we lost Stephen Sondheim this year. A real legend, of course. He had so many great plays, and this is when he was working as a lyricist. He hadn't become a working composer of music of the Broadway stage yet, because Leonard Bernstein, the great Leonard Bernstein, wrote the music to this. I was really fortunate a couple of weeks ago during our spring break to go to Washington, D.C. and do some work in the Library of Congress, and I held in my hands Leonard Bernstein's score to West Side Story. And was able to copy whatever I wanted out of it. And so I came home among the stacks of paper, actually on a thumb drive, of things was Bernstein's manuscript of this song, treasured possession. So it's another reason I'm so happy they're doing this. Enjoy something from West Side Story.
Thank you. much for coming. And to those of you somewhere across our country, around the world, I know there's a lot of streamers watching that paid and donated to our music scholarship. So thank you, everyone. To close out our first half of our program, as you can see, extraordinaire, Jen Martin, about to play for us. I'm just going to let her tune, keep talking a little bit, and then she will begin. Enjoy.
A few years ago. Switch? A few years ago, through a bunch of circumstances that takes too long to explain, I got to spend a day hanging around with Peter, Paul, and Mary. And it was before I really played guitar. I played guitar as a kid. But I gave up guitar and then I came back to it a few years ago and started playing solo guitar, which is a whole other kind of playing guitar. But through a set of circumstances, I got to spend the day with Peter Pony. And I was hanging around backstage with their accompanist, a guy named Paul Prestopino, who himself is a folk legend. He was accompanist to all sorts of folk acts, including John Denver. And we were sitting around playing a little bit backstage, and I was playing the tune I'm about to play for you in a really kind of beginning guitar kind of style. I hear footsteps behind me. This is backstage at 10 in the morning before an evening concert. And I hear humming starting with the song. And then I hear full-on singing of the song. And she comes around beside the side of me, and I'm like, holy cow, that's Mary Travers. I haven't met her yet. And I'm just like, hold it together. And she sang the rest of the song with us. And then she looked at me and said, who the hell are you? So we explained why we were there. She said about this John Denver song, she said, Lord, I really miss him. So these are two songs by John Denver. you very much, everybody. Enjoy the intermission. We'll be not too long, and we'll come back with a bunch of other great, great music. Thanks a lot.
Welcome back to the second part of our soiree this evening. Again, we appreciate you all being here very much. You know Idona well by now. She's done a whole variety of things, and she's about to do some more, and then there's some more to come. We're glad that Idona showed up tonight. She's going to be playing the Sonata in F minor, Kirkpatrick number 466, Longo number 118. Those are index numbers in the Scarlatti oeuvre. It's always a good night when you can say oeuvre. And you know her already as a fine, fine musician. So it's playing the music of Domenico Scarlatti. This is Idona Cabrinha. We had a whole mess of hiring here in the music department around 2004, 2005. I came in 2004, Lordy, 18 years now, it's 18th year here. The following year, Ron McCarley came, Cassie Tarantino came, and Marcy Irving. Marcy teaches history of rock and roll on our campus, and her day job, so to speak, is singing classical music, both in choirs and opera and so forth. She's the founder of an opera company we have on campus here, Central Coast Gilbert and Sullivan, for which I have the honor of conducting. And she's known those operas, those Gilbert and Sullivan operas, since a kid. I mean, literally, when she was like five, she knew all the words to all the Gilbert and Sullivan operas. And now she's fulfilling a dream of bringing those wonderful operas to the community. This summer, Ruttigore, on Father's Day weekend. Hope you might want to come. So, degrees from Cal State Northridge and University of Nevada, Reno. This is Marcy Irving. Thank you. So this is a tune, this is Marcy's tune, but I talk more than she does. This is a song that was brought to us by Peter, Paul, and Mary, by a songwriter named Sally Fingeret. She's a wonderful songwriter and composer. She's a member of a female quartet that tours all around the world, and their name is the Four Bitchin' Babes. This home is where the heart is.
He loves to hear my little baby's stories. She's the gift I share. She's his companion. She's the string on the kite. She guides him into the
jazz. It's going to be very cool. You know George? No, you don't know George. Yeah. But you know George. So George Stone is teaches and is the founder of our recording arts program here. He's a wonderful musician, mostly in the jazz field, but people don't know he's also a fantastic classical musician. He conducted the Cuesta Wind Ensemble some years ago. Fantastic trumpet player, fantastic pianist, former division chair of performing arts here at the college. You know Dylan and you know Tom. Dave Becker, nobody knows Dave Becker, really. Not really. Known mostly as a jazz musician around town. He's one of the busiest giggers in the area, fantastic players. If you haven't heard him, you'll find that out now. Also teaches in the recording arts program, bachelor's degrees and master's degrees from Florida, and we are really thankful for the presence of all of these people. So here we are, one of the Bard Jazz Ensembles.
Thank you.
another hand for our alumni, Tom Brown, who's sitting in on drums. Our next artist, who's starting off by doing an original tune of hers, is known really nationally. Inga Swearingen has appeared on stage and screen and radio and all sorts of places, and she's a well-loved performer and person in this county. She teaches jazz voice lessons on our campus and sometimes some jazz history as well, and playing, accompanying herself on guitar. This is Inga Swearingen.
Take this for granted. There's an extra lot of catching up going on backstage, as you can imagine, because we haven't been together playing music together, and this is so special to be doing this. And thank you for being a part of it. In April of 2020, right after the shelter in place had been issued, Barry Goyette and I got to film and felt the need to film a live stream. And we did so. And I had read this essay by Charles Eisenstein. And it's called Coronation. And it talks about, really, our appreciation of how incredibly precious these social interactions are of being together, and how hopefully we can move forward inspired and energetically reclaim these social interactions and coming together to make something in our future. And I think that it also could provide, and did hopefully provide, a pause for us to think about perhaps something, creating something bigger than just restoring normal, and that you know, there are things that we could take that we've learned from this and move forward. So this is based on Charles Eisenstein's Coronation, and I wrote this. It's called Stunned. Thank you. Shall we double down on protecting ourselves? Declare war on everything and proceed as before. Insulation, isolation, domination. Star, and I suggested, how about we do when you Wish Upon a Star? And George Stone came back with an arrangement, and it was just so amazing. I am so honored and appreciative. Thank you very much, and thank you very much to everybody for tonight. I'm gonna get this thing out of the way.
Thank you.
fix them. Thank you very much. Okay, we've made it to the end, almost. Thank you again for coming, everybody. Wasn't that just beautiful? Love your voice, love all of our faculty. So in a moment, our next piece is titled Offering for Peace. And I hear some slide projector coming down. This is a piece that I arranged. It's inspired by a composition called Spiegel im Spiegel, Mirror in Mirror, by Arvo Pärt, who's a living composer. And his music is actually inspired by Gregorian chant. Happens to also be a big religious holiday this weekend. Thank you for sharing your weekend with us. But with the recent events in our world, especially in Ukraine and Russia and Poland and so many supporting European nations, I just felt like something was calling me to do something today that we could share in our art and creativity. So I hope you enjoy this simple piece. And I actually wanted to invite everyone to take a big breath in and an exhale out.
Thank you.
you, Idona, very much. All right, and we've come to the end. We thank you all once again for joining us this evening. It's been a wonderful treat to have you with us in person once again. Here's to many more. Check out your program. There are some dates of some events coming up that you might be interested in. We hope that you are. Thanks again to the cast and crew for all of your work this evening. We have one new person joining us this set, right?
Yes, he's warming up backstage.
Okay, well, it's about time. On trumpet, one of the busiest kickers in town, wonderful player out of Cal State Long Beach, this is Bob Bennett.
Do 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 do.